Hello and welcome back to the Charger Bulletin News. I'm Corina Rodriguez.
And I'm Nicole Rivera, and we are here today with this week's top stories. At the end of every semester, students are asked to fill out course evaluations in order to view their grades early. But what actually happens to them? According to Associate Provost of the College of Arts and Sciences, Stuart Seidel, they are used to improve courses. Deans and department chairs help professors with struggling course scores improve their courses. If a professor continues to receive poor evaluations, it can affect whether or not they are invited back to the university. Seidel encourages students to fill out the evaluations, not only to see their grades, but to reflect on the courses they are taking. For more information on this, visit thechargerbulletin.com.
Every year, students are offered the opportunity to apply for the President's Public Service Fellowship, and time to apply is almost up. The fellowship is an 11-week program over the summer that offers free on-campus housing and a 35-hour week stipend to a select group of students. Students will work in one of the various fellows doing nonprofit or community service work in either the West Haven or New Haven communities. Applications can be found on Charger Connection on the Office of Community Service page. An application along with a resume and letter of recommendation is required. The deadline is Monday, February 18th. With the playoffs on the horizon, the Chargers have some work to do. Last night, they took on Pace University in Pleasantville for a win. How are the rest of our Chargers doing?
The women's basketball team also squared off against Pace last night, but fell to the Setters 68-61. Junior Micah Womack set off scoring 30 points and pulling down 18 rebounds, both career highs, but it was not enough as the Chargers have now lost two in a row and seven of their last eight. They will look to bounce back Saturday when they return to Charger Gym to host St. Rose at 1:30 p.m. It is senior night for the women as well, and the team will honor its four seniors, center Katia O'Shea, and guards Sienna Van Dyke, Alex Kerr, and Aaliyah Christie. Festivities are set to begin at 1:20 p.m. On the men's side, they also faced Pace yesterday, downing the Setters 80-69. Junior Roy Kay tied his career high with 22 points, along with a team-high 9 rebounds, as the team shot a season-high of 62.2% from the field. The team has now won 3 of its last 4 and currently sit in second place in the division standing, a game behind Lemoine. They will also return to the Charger Gym Saturday at 3:30 p.m. when they face off with St. Rose. The team will honor its lone senior, forward Najee Larcher, prior to tip-off. And the spring season is finally upon us. The Chargers softball team is set to arrive in Myrtle Beach, North Carolina, today in preparation for the Snowbird Freeze-Out Tournament to open the 2019 campaign. The team will play 6 games to start the season, beginning Clarion and Felician on Friday, Millersville and Kutztown on Saturday, and conclude with games versus Liberty Rock and Georgian Court on Sunday. The first game on each day will begin at 10 a.m. and the second game will start at noon. Live stats will provide on newhavenchargers.com and a live stream will be provided on Facebook Live.
That concludes our show. Thank you for joining us today for updates on latest campus news.
Be sure to pick up this week's paper and newsstands across campus. Due to Tuesday's weather, we were unable to deliver them at our regularly scheduled time, but rest assured, every stand has a new stack of papers.
Despite the paper delay, we post articles online at thechargerbulletin.com every week. Check it out along with the upcoming episode of The Charge Up. Stay tuned to date with the latest sport news. We thank you for joining us today. I'm Nadine Bourne.
I'm Corina Rodriguez.
And I'm Nicole Rivera. We'll see you next week.